What the fuck? Her vocals are coming through on this song, yes. The instrumental, the beat makes me feel like a bad bitch. Hey, what is up everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Frassix and I'm really, really excited for this video in particular because I'm gonna be reacting to Katy Perry's new album called Smile. We've known about this for a while. The day is finally here. It's been forever since she released like a last actual album with Witness in 2017, and now it's 2020, over 3 years later, and now we are getting a new album with new songs. And it's literally crazy that the day before, Katy also gave birth to babycat. And if you guys didn't already know, her name is Daisy Dove Bloom, and I'm just like, it was so exciting just to see that, me waking up and like seeing the announcement, and I was so happy, and that made me even more excited to get into Smile, and I'm just really ready for this. I mean, she shared snippets and stuff on Smile Sundays, which if you guys don't know what Smile Sundays is, it's basically like where Katy basically like webcammed us and like we all tuned in into her, and then she shared like snippets and stories and just answered questions and shared like merch and stuff like that. And she did share snippets of a few of the songs, and by snippets she basically like shared the entire song, but you know, I still forgive her for that because I only listened to them once, so it's not like I actually remember them or something like that. But I did record myself for some of them. If you guys want to check that out, those might be at the end of the video if I remember to edit them in. But yeah, it's just absolutely crazy that for me personally, I was with her at the very beginning of this Smile era.
Okay, so we just got done with the event, and guess who's behind me? It's Katy. She's like literally right there, and I'm just freaking out. This is super exciting.
Even though at the time it wasn't really a Smile era, it was just basically the KP5 era. And it wasn't even like the KP5 era, it was just a droplet era. But
hi, Katy.
Hi, baby.
Hey. But be with her in that room when Never Really Over was premiering was just absolutely crazy. And little did either of us know back then that now it's basically Smile. And I'm just so happy for this, and I'm just really ready to get into this reaction. If you guys haven't watched any of my album reviews on this channel, I basically just do these things where I just list out the track list, and then I basically just claim three songs that I haven't listened to yet, or I've heard snippets of, but again, I don't remember them, so they're basically fresh in my mind. So anyways, so I just choose three songs from the track list that I haven't listened to yet, that aren't officially out, that I think I will like. And I don't know, usually I'm right about my hunches. It's just based off like a hunch. It's not really based off of anything in particular. So my top three claim tracks, no particular order, are Teary Eyes, Champagne Problems, and Only Love. I don't know, there's just something about those songs. I mean, like, I'm pretty sure all the songs are gonna be bops, but I don't know, hopefully at least I like one of them, but I'm pretty sure, again, I'm gonna like the entire album, so there's no need to worry about that. I've been freaking out about this album in particular on my social media accounts. If you guys don't follow me on my social media accounts, you guys should definitely do that just to keep up with all the Smile hype and the babycat hype. I mean, we can't call her babycat anymore because it's Daisy Dove, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, I'm just so happy. You guys have no idea how happy I am that she, you know, gave birth, and then the Smile album, like, honestly, it's beyond amazing. I'm just gonna stop talking and start getting into this reaction. So without further ado, here's my reaction to Katy Perry's brand new album called Smile. Okay, here we go. So the first song off of Smile is Never Really Over. And I think we know what I think about that song. Absolutely love it. I adore it. It just makes me so happy every time I listen to this song because it just reminds me of like my trip to California, and then of course the Never Really Over premiere event, and it just reminds me of that, and I just absolutely love that song so much. The second song from Smile is Cry About It Later, and I think there was a snippet that she shared of it on Smile Sundays, but I just really just want to listen to it because I forgot what it sounded like, so here we go. Ooh, she sounds like so gentle in this song. I love the... It's building up. Oh my god, I can't deal with this. What? Okay. Shameless Summer. That was part of the bouquet thing. Oh, I love that. Oh my god. I love how it's like fast. What the fuck? Oh my god. Yo. It's like so like sensual and like fun and oh my god. Okay, I love how funky it is. Oh my. The guitar, her voice. What the heck? It's the big what do you ever girl sing. Just everything, the production, her voice, just I love this. I should have claimed this. Oh my god. Okay, they are not gonna be like a bridge, it's just gonna be like a oh my god, there's gonna be a guitar solo. I love this, I love this, I love this, I love this so much. Is that it? Oh my god, oh my. I don't know what to say about the song. I love it so much, and I did not expect that at all. And just like the production of it was like really good, but it was like really, really good. And then her voice, she sounded like so like sensual and like calm, but then like she came full force with her voice too. And I'm just like, and the electric guitar solo, I was just like, I am living for this. I absolutely love it so much. Oh my gosh, I should have claimed that as a claim track. Oh my gosh. Speaking of claim tracks, track number 3 is my claim song, and that is up next, and it is Teary Eyes. And I think I remember it being a bop. So let's just get into track number 3, Teary Eyes. Oof. This is just gonna be a fun song. I can feel it. Oh, I love. It's like kind of like. Her voice is kind of like echoey in a way. And I love the lyrics too. Oh my god. This is building up. Holy heck. Oh yes. What the? What? No. What the hell? It's just like. Yo. Yo, I did not. I love the productions. We're only 3 tracks in, and I love the production for each of the songs. I just want to like drive down the highway like at 100 miles per hour just blasting this song. It also makes me miss the club. Yes. This is so good. This is so good. Cry About It Later and Teary Eyes. I love when she goes higher with her voice too. But I love this. Iconic. Okay. Just keep on dancing with those lyrics. Come on, vocals and the backing vocals and the production and everything. Oh, okay. So that was Teary Eyes, and that literally. I'm glad that that was my first claim track. I mean, I love Cry About Later, but oh my god, Teary Eyes. like, I think this is the next single, or if it's not a single during this Smile era, I'll be really upset, because that was really good. It was just so fun, so carefree, so upbeat. Like I said, I would want to like drive down the highway maybe at the middle of the night, just like blasting this song, just going at it, or just running, or just something, or going to the club and just dancing and being carefree. I just love the production of the songs so far. They are amazing. So good job to everyone that worked on that song. And oh my gosh, like, whew, I can't imagine what I'm gonna react to for the rest of this album. Track number 4 off of Smile is Daisies, and I reacted to that already. I really love it. It's the first official single from the album, and I just absolutely love it. It's super like acoustic-y, like not too acoustic-y, but it's like definitely more laid back than most for singles, but it's definitely like it I don't know, it just makes me feel so empowered and happy. And of course, you know, Daisies, and then Daisy Dove, like I love that symbolism, and I just love the song overall. Track number 5 is Resilient, so let's get into Resilient.
I'll be right if I'm on the rainbows.
Okay. I love the plucking. I love the when she goes low, because it's like you can hear the vibrating in her voice. I love the bass and like the subtleness of whatever those snap claps things are. Sing! Yeah, and I love the strings too. There's a lot of flower symbolism in this album. Okay, it's like gradually building. I love that. Okay, distortion. This is like chill, but it's so powerful at the same time. Hey, her vocals are coming through on this song, yes.
Ooh.
Yes. Oh my god. Okay, so that was Resilient, and I just absolutely just love how like it stays constantly chill, but it's like so powerful, and I think that really shines through on Katy's vocals especially. For some reason, her voice in that like really reminds me of like one of the boys, like the era, for some reason. I don't know, I guess it's just mostly because like she's really just using like, I don't know, that just her voice, like her voice inside of her, like that powerful, like, I don't know, because she really had to use that for the rock aspect of one of the boys, because, you know, rock is like the instruments are loud, and of course she has to like really sing to be heard in a way. But for this song, like she really like takes that and just like uses it to her advantage, especially like with the chillness of the instrumental. But that doesn't mean that it's a bad thing. Like, I absolutely love that it's chill, but it's chill but not chill, let's just say that. But I absolutely love that, and I was surprised that I actually really like that. So number 6 is Not the End of the World. She shared a snippet of this on Smile Sundays. Again, I forgot about it, but I can't wait to hear it, so let's just get into
it. It's not the end of the world. No, no.
She shared the snippet. Yes. This is gonna be epic. Her vocals.
It's not the end. You can catch a star if the sky is falling down. There's a golden
light. Yes. The instrumental, the beat makes me feel like a bad bitch. This is like Dark Horse's like older, seductive, like sister. We're halfway through the album and I absolutely love every single song. Am I the only one? Yes, sing.
It's not the end of the, no, not the end of the world.
I always fall for that.
Anything you like, you can tame the dragon, you're not afraid to fight, not afraid to fight.
What's that from? That's a song. Where? Who sings that? I remember loving that song. That's gonna really bother me. I'm gonna look it up afterwards.
Goodbye.
Yo, that is a bop. I love it so much. Like, the snippet that she shared on Smile Sundays is great, but that doesn't do it justice at all. Oh my god. Yo. But the song, like, she sings, like, na 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 na, you know, don't say goodbye. But, you know, it's basically just like the na 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 na, hey, hey, goodbye. Who sings that? I can't. That's gonna really bother me, so I'm just gonna look it up real quick. Okay, I don't know, it's not showing up for me, but I know it's a song. So if you guys know what song I'm talking about, just leave in the comment below, please. Because I think that's gonna annoy me for a little bit. Okay, track number 7 is Smile, and we all know how I feel about Smile. I reacted to it. All the reactions to all the songs that have been already released before the album was released will be in the description, so you guys should definitely check those out. But yeah, I love Smile. I love the music video, even though YouTube keeps on taking it down for some reason, even though other YouTubers have their Smile music video up. And I'm talking about like the official video, not like the performance video. But yeah, I absolutely love the song and the video. It's so fun. And let me just say, and let me just like call it and like claim it, that if she does go on tour, if Katy does go on tour, I claim that Smile will be like the intro song to the tour, and then Never Really Over will be the closing song. So if that's true, quote me on that. And I already claim that, so you guys should definitely remember that. Track number 8 is Champagne Problems. That is my second claim track. And I am still upset that it's not featuring Harry Styles, because that was like the rumor for the longest time. And then there were some other artists, and basically like the entire music industry was just featured on Champagne Problems. But let's just get into the song itself. So track number 8. What instrumental is that? Is that like a... Okay, this is gonna be like throwbacky funky. It's funky. It's definitely, I love funkiness in songs for some reason. And we can't forget the clap. Okay. Ooh. I love the violins in this entire album. Okay. I just love how the songs start off like kind of subtle, but then they like keep on building like little by little. And I just love her lyrics too. This album is such a bop. Oh, she's going lower their voice. What was that? I love that. It was like the song went like whoa, and then her voice went like bop. Oh my god! What? It's like very high and like very like... Ooh! Sounds... I feel like I should be like disco dancing or something. Yes! I definitely feel like I should be like at a disco right now. Under a disco ball. Hey, that surprised me a lot more, because I think she did share a snippet of this on Smile Sundays, but I didn't want to listen to it. Not because, you know, I didn't want to listen to it, but just because, like, I just wanted to save my reaction for this reaction. And yo, like, that was amazing. It was, I just love all the songs, and I just love all the productions of the songs on this album, and especially this song, because I'm just like, it's so funky. Like, this is, I feel like, the funkiest yet that we've heard on this album, but like in the best way. And I just feel like I should just be like, a lot of these songs, like she said, this album was gonna be like very like just dancing, carefree, and I really feel that with all these songs. It just feels like, you know, just, you know, throw your cares away, like just have fun. And this song in this album is fun, and I absolutely love that. And her voice and the funkiness of this song was just amazing. So yeah. Okay, so track number 9 is Tucked, and she did say it was a little bit sensual. So I wonder what's getting tucked. Let's find out, shall we? So track number 9 is Tucked. Okay, this is...
No one knows, knows where my mind goes.
This is not what I thought it was gonna be at all. I just love... It sounds very like West Coast-y. Okay, I love the little background. I just really love the funkiness of this album. Ooh, this is like so flirty. Ooh. Oh, babe, I love how she says that. Okay, this sounds so flirty. I love it. I think I know what this song is about. But you guys get what I say when I say like it's West Coasty? Like, I feel like she's like cruising down the California boardwalk in roller skates, just like blasting this like on a stereo. Oh, did you hear some trumpets? Yes, I did. I can only imagine how she's gonna perform this on tour if she goes on tour for this. It's gonna be so fun. I can guarantee it's gonna be fun. This album is exceeding my expectations. Everyone, come on, clap. Clap with me, come on. Yo, I don't know what else to say about this album, because this album is just really, really good. There's a theme. There's definitely a theme with the songs and the instrumentals and the production, but it works. At least for me, it does. And I really like this, and I love this song. She sounds like so sensual and flirty, and like if you really listen to the lyrics, you can like definitely tell like what she's talking about, or at least I can imply or think about what she's talking about, and hopefully I'm right. And I'm not gonna say it because, you know, like it's up to interpretation. But if you guys have an idea what Tucked is about, or what do you guys think Tucked is about, like if you have an idea, leave it in the comments down below and we can, you know, discuss. Track number 10 is Harley's in Hawaii, and that was released almost a year ago. Like, honestly, like, granted, it was released like in the fall slash almost winter time, and it should have been released in the summertime because it's a perfect summer bop. It's probably the chillest, I think, out of the entire album if I really like try to think about it and compare it. But it, like, I don't know, I absolutely love it, and a lot of people don't like it, which I'm really surprised about. And I'm just like, why? It's like literally so chill, but it's like sexy in a way, and I just absolutely love that so much. And if you guys haven't watched it, the link for that will be in the description, so watch it. That and the music video. The music video was so aesthetic, and she looks so good, like so good. And track number 11 is the last track that I haven't heard yet, and it's Only Love. It's my third claim track. So technically that means the album is almost done, or after this song, or after, you know. So I'm just like, I don't know how to feel about this, because I'm like, I don't want this album to end. It's just so fun. So, you know, let's just get into it. So track number 11, the last track that I haven't heard yet, is called Only Love. Okay, so this is gonna be like one of the chiller songs on the album, I think.
86,400 seconds in a day. I swear lately,
that reminds me of like that musical song.
One day left to live.
Okay. It's gonna be a very emotional song, huh?
Oh, I call my mother and tell her I'm sorry.
This is like a very emotional song, but like powerful. I like the message of this song. This is like one of those like empowering songs. I think the people that made Firework also helped Katy make the song. Am I right? Sing. Our vocals, yes. I love like the drums and just how impactful and forceful it sounds, but like in the best way. Come on, sing. All love, all love. That was a cute song. That was a lot that I did not actually expect that at all, because I didn't really know what Only Love was about. But wow, that was way more heartfelt than I thought it was gonna be. And oh dang, like I actually really like it, because it's I feel like it's different than the rest of the songs. Not like too different that it's not like a standout or anything in a bad way, but it's just like it's really interesting, and I absolutely love the message of the song, and I just love the production, like I said, for this song as well as every other song. But I absolutely love it. And then that leads in, that's the last track technically, because number 12 is What Makes a Woman, and I've already heard that as well and reacted to it. So that basically, that's the entire album. That is the Smile album. And of course there's the bonus target track, High in Your Supply. I haven't heard that since I don't have the album yet from Target, but I will get it and hopefully I'll react to it and post it on here. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, that is the Smile album. And honestly I feel like cohesive wise, I feel like, and production wise, this is probably her best album. Like I said, like it's, I don't know, like I feel like there's a very like constant theme throughout this entire album and throughout all the songs, because it really feels like, of course there's like a funky aspect to it, and like the drums and the beats and the snaps and the claps and everything, but I just feel like overall there's just, it's just fun, it's just carefree. Like even some of the slower songs like Only Love and What Makes a Woman, you can definitely tell that there is some kind of consistency, and you can tell that she really put her heart and soul into this album. Not that she didn't put her heart and soul into like the past albums, because of course she, you know, she changes and evolves as a person, as we all do. I've grown up with her, starting with the Teenage Dream album essentially, and seeing her grow through Teenage Dream and then through Prism and then through Witness, and I thought that, you know, she couldn't outdo herself with like the next album, but she keeps on doing that, and like she does that with this album. And like I said, and I stand by this as when I'm recording this, is that I think that production wise and thematic wise, and just I think this is her best album. Yeah, which is funny because I think a lot of the critics are hating on it and saying it's like too poppy, but I'm just like, it's not, like literally I know, like, and not to shade any artist, but like I know like a few albums that were released this year that got such praise that literally they sound essentially almost the same, not just like this album, but just they sound the same in general, and in a way got kind of boring after a while. But this song, but this album just never gets boring. It like always keeps you on your toes. So I don't get why there's so much hate on this album, and it's not from the fans, it's more so just from the critics. And I'm just like, what do you want from Katy? She, when you say she's gone too different, you want her to like go back to her pop roots, then when she's going back to her pop roots, you want her to do something different. Like, what the hell? Like, that's just so, it makes me so mad how everyone treats Katy nowadays, especially like even with like the her like announcing the birth and like her being pregnant and everything. Like, no, like barely anyone famous like acknowledges her, and like that was super ironic, because like I know like a few years ago, back when Katy was at her prime, like everyone was praising her, and now no one's like giving her a second glance, which is like absolutely stupid. Which I guess that's why we, as Katy cats and as fans of Katy, just really just need to help her out and just, you know, we're her family at this point. And of course she's gonna have, you know, her real family, but you know, us as Katy cats, we've always been a tight-knit family. And I just absolutely adore Katy so much, as you can tell obviously. And I just absolutely love this album. And I don't know, I feel like she said this might be a visual album, and hopefully we will get some visuals for all these songs, because I really like, as you can tell and as I've said, I really like all these songs. And there were some surprising ones like Resilient and Only Love, but then there were some that I really, really liked, such as Cry About It Later, Teary Eyes, and Not the End of the World, and that was surprising as well. But I absolutely love all of the songs. But what is your favorite song? Do you guys have a favorite? Do you guys have a least favorite? Do you guys have some that you want to be singles? Like, tell me down below which ones you think will be singles in this era, if there will be any more music videos or performances or anything. Just leave those comments down below and I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can, because yeah, that is pretty much it for me, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really, really enjoyed reacting to the Smile album, Katy's newest album. She's back, she's better than ever. I don't care what anyone else thinks. I absolutely love this album and I'm gonna promote the heck out of this album. So you guys better follow me on my social media accounts and help me promote this album, because it is, I feel like it's gonna be very underrated as compared to like other albums. And we gotta show that this album is just as great, if not better than some of the albums that were released this year. Just saying, sips tea. Yeah. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, you know, all the usual things. If you guys want to see any of my reactions to other songs, the links for those will be in the description below. And you know, just, you know, thank you Katy for this great album and just for being an amazing person. And congrats again on Daisy for you and Orlando, and hopefully, you know, everything will turn out okay. And I know everything will turn out okay. So, and I'm glad that you got back your smile. And until the next video, the Wonder Woman song, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Boo. We're not gonna play a little bit of Not the End of the World.
Her voice. Oh my. Oh my God, it's so.
Do we want to play?
Oh my God.
Let's play.
Stop, stop.
Let's play.
What?
Should we play a little snippet of What Makes a Woman?
Oh, bro.
This is What Makes a Woman.
Stop.
And
I don't want to listen to it because
just a little snippet.
I want to react to it, but it's like, it's going to be in the reaction anyway, so I'm just... I'm not ready.
It's loading.
Stop. Okay, so it is kind of acoustic-y like she said it was gonna be.
Isn't the way I talk sweet? And the way my skin is soft. Oh. I can be a bitch. Oh. When you keep your fingers crossed. Isn't the way that I praise you? The way that I please you? How fast I change my mind. Get scared that I might leave.
I love her voice.
It's been your whole life, but you couldn't describe what makes a woman. It's always been a perfect mystery.
Oh, she looks so good to look.
It's been your whole life, but you couldn't describe what makes a woman. That's what makes a woman to me.
It's so cute. It's like kind of like country, but
there
it's
it
like.
Is. Okay. I got two snippets.
Where are you?
Probably not allowed to do that.
Probably not, but oh my God. It's not the end of the world, and then I want to. oh my
that's
God.
That's what makes a woman. And there's so much more. Stop.
What are we going to play?
Okay. pushing a button on streaming. Let's just keep that.
I was about to be like, oh my gosh.
Are we good? Are we still on? I gotta check. Okay, I'm good. For anyone that's tuning in now, we're playing a little smile roulette or a cassette roulette. Ooh, stop. Let's see where we're at now.
What is this? What the fuck? Teary-eyed.
Teary-eyed, that's not fair. That's probably one of my favorite songs on the record, so I'm gonna rewind it for you. And play a little bit.
I can't. I do deserve new content.
I've seen all of the different makeups and artworks, and it seems like Teary Eyes is really popping off.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited for you to hear a little bit of this song.
Is it like the next single? Because I'm claiming that song. I mean... What?
Not here. Let's cry about it later. It's not
cry about it later. Oh, I can't do this. Stop.
Where I'll be for the next forever. Just rocking back and forth.
Oh, God.
Well, that was a fun smile Sunday.
It was.
And thank you for joining us.
You're welcome.
And see you next time. I love you. I'm gonna put more signed CDs up.
You better.
And here we go. See you August 28th.
Oh, bye, Katy.
Love ya.
Bye, Katy.
This is me signing off. Got all my diapers ready to go.
This might be the last time we see her, like, pregnant.
Bye,
without...
Guys.
I'm gonna cry. Bye. Bye, Katy. That might be the last time we see Katy pregnant until the 28th.